Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today, we're looking at the woman who's the mother of us all. Just before we get started, I will say that this video is brought to you by Ancestry DNA. Discover your family history by going to ancestry.com/brainfood. So all humans can be traced back to a single female known in science circles as Mitochondrial Eve. This woman is thought to be the mother of all humans alive today. Seems like a pretty big claim for scientists to make, so how do they know this? The simple explanation is that when an egg is fertilized by a sperm, the DNA from the father and mother join together in a process known as recombination. Certain DNA is only passed down from the mother or the father. All mitochondrial DNA comes exclusively from the mother as an exact copy. Over time, however, there will occur predictable mutations to mitochondrial DNA. Biologists can compare samples from individuals to determine how closely they are related. The fewer predictable mutations, the closer the relationship. The predictability of these mutations allows biologists to estimate the time at which a certain mutation occurred, i.e., when the ancestor lived. Beginning in 1987, several studies have been conducted that show all humans alive today have the same female ancestor, and she lived approximately 200,000 years ago. A more detailed explanation is as follows. Mitochondria are a type of organelle found in almost all complex cells. They are known as the power plants of the cell because they supply an enzyme, more accurately a coenzyme, known as adenosine triphosphate, ATP. This ATP is the source for the chemical energy needed by a cell to perform a wide range of functions. The DNA found within mitochondria have two benefits. They have 37 genes that rarely mutate, so they can easily be used as the model for an evolutionary clock, and these same genes have subsections that mutate in a predictable manner, so biologists can use it as a reference for age. Sperm have only a few mitochondria, and thus mitochondrial DNA, in their tails. They use them to power their quest to the egg. As sperm enters the egg, only the chromosomes found in the head of the sperm are preserved and used in the recombination process to create new cells. This is because the rest of the sperm cell is broken down by enzymes within the egg. So the mitochondrial DNA in the tail is lost, and the only type to survive is supplied by the mother. As the human population grows from one generation to the next, women transfer this DNA evidence to their daughters. They, in turn, transfer it to their daughters. Should a woman only have a son, their mitochondrial DNA is lost because it will never be passed to his children. However, there have been a few rare cases in which mitochondrial DNA was found recombined from both parents. Some skeptics of the mitochondrial Eve theory use this to cast doubt on the hypothesis. This opposition is somewhat dubious, as those few cases occur in people who are typically far too biologically deficient to have offspring. Thus, the prevailing assumption is that these unfortunate people have something seriously wrong with their DNA, and the abnormal recombination of mitochondrial DNA will never get into the human population because of it. Even though biologists have shown that all people are descended from one person, this does not mean that only one female was alive at that time. It simply means only one set of genes have been passed down from a single point in history. Most researchers agree that this so-called Eve was not the only woman alive, because the fossil record shows much older specimens. From Java Man at about 800,000 years to Lucy, the earliest known remains, which are approximately 1 to 4 million years old. So there are several theories about how just one set of genes could have survived. The most likely is a bottleneck of the human population that would set the stage for an evolutionary lucky mother. There have been several possible bottlenecks in history. One report, written in 1998, showed approximately 70,000 years ago, humanity was down to around 15,000 people. It showed the reason behind the bottleneck was an ice age that lasted about 1,000 years. Other reasons bottlenecks could have happened are an asteroid impact or volcanic eruption causing drastic climate change, a continuous widespread plague, or any such situation that caused male offspring to have a better chance of survival, leaving relatively few women around to pass on their genes. While no definitive proof of these occurring exists, most researchers believe a combination of one or all of these factors are behind why we have a single common female ancestor. And if you're wondering if we all have a common male ancestor, there is another type of genetic test that can trace all humans alive today back through their father's ancestors. This uses the Y chromosome and shows that all people today can trace their lineage back to a single father known as Y chromosome Adam. Why Adam lived at a completely different time than mitochondrial Eve, approximately 60 to 90,000 years ago. But how can this be? Well, mitochondrial Eve is simply the most recent common ancestor of mitochondrial DNA. Y-chromosomal Adam is the most recent common ancestor for Y-DNA. Thus, they did not have to be a couple for both of their genes to be the source for all current humans. So, as I mentioned at the top of this video is brought to you by Ancestry DNA. Ancestry DNA is a service that makes it super easy to discover your unique family history. Their DNA test is different than the test we've discussed today because it looks at your autosomes. Humans have 22 pairs of autosomes and one pair of sex chromosomes. 2X if you are female and 1X and 1Y if you are male. This type of test checks your autosomal chromosomes and in addition to finding genealogical matches, it will also provide an estimate of your overall ethnic ancestry. This is terrific technology. When I was a kid, my gran spent years building a family tree with limited results, but if she had access to the Ancestry DNA test or Ancestry's online record database, the process would have been simpler and more fulfilling. As part of this sponsorship, Ancestry sent me a kit. I just had to spit in a tube and send it back to them for analysis. You can get your own kit with 10% off if you go to ancestry.com/brainfood or by clicking the link in the description. After a few weeks, I got my results back and have really been enjoying what I found out. For example, I know that my gran's family were from Yorkshire in the UK, and the test shows a strong cluster of my DNA coming from there, as you can see here. My results also provided a few surprises, like me being 10% Italian Greek. That's something my gran never told me about. Another great feature is getting to see relatives who have also taken the test. I've already found a bunch of fourth cousins. All this, and I'll continue to get new relative matches as more people take the test. So join me in getting your ancestry analyzed with Ancestry DNA and find out your heritage without any hassle. Ancestry sends you the kit, you give them a saliva sample and mail it back 6 to 8 weeks later, and your results are ready. It's normally $99, but if you go to ancestry.com/brainfood or click the link in the description, you get 10% off. Leave us a comment below or use the hashtag #MyAncestry on social to let us know about your results. And that also helps support Today I Found Out and keeps this show going. That's ancestry.com/brainfood, and as always, thanks for watching.